are chatting with Michael Willett. How are you doing today, man?
I'm great, thanks. How are you?
Awesome. So let's get into this episode. This is like Shane's episode. We get to see more about his relationship with Duke. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, Duke is this macho, kind of hetero acting guy that Shane sees and feels like he needs to, you know, catch him, so to speak. You know, he's cute and he's exactly what Shane is looking for. And I think Shane likes guys who are slightly unattainable, so.
But you know, we saw with Pablo how he's, you know, celibate.
Exactly. And, you know, Shane's no longer celibate. Let's just put it that way.
So this season is really big for Shane. You know, we get to see his relationship with Duke go on, you know, pretty long. And can you talk about how this season has been different for you with a love interest that's kind of more long-term?
Yeah, I feel like the first season, with Pablo, Shane really had to fight for him. And there's not as much of a fight. You know, Duke seems to really like Shane. And, you know, their feelings are mutual. They're just kind of caught in a tricky situation because Duke is older. He has a career that he is trying to, you know, maintain and start, really. And this being gay could potentially threaten his whole situation. And it makes it very uncomfortable for Shane.
So in this episode, Shane and Duke, you know, something comes between them, and that is Duke's dad. Can you talk about their relationship and also how it's different from, you know, Shane's relationship with his dad?
Well, it's really complicated because it seems like for the most part, Duke's father is really accepting of him, of him being gay, but he doesn't see it as a positive career move. And Shane has a big issue with that because Shane is all about people being upfront and truthful and open and honest. And so this is really breaking all of Shane's rules. And he's willing to take a chance for this guy.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Michael.
Thank you.